So welcome to this webinar on medical devices for literature searches, or actually it should be literature searches for medical devices. My name's Tessa Heffernan, and I'm in the product specialist team at Dialog Solutions. Dialog has a long history of providing high quality content and technology to the pharmaceutical industry. And we've been tracking the new medical device regulations with some interest. And we're particularly interested in the fact that literature is now more important than it was before. So what I want to cover today is the role of literature in the new regulations. So in May 2021, some new regulations will come into force, which will affect the way that the EMA requires oversight compliance with any manufacturers of medical devices. So we'll look briefly at the requirements, and then I want to focus on the role of literature, and then specifically, because that's my area of expertise, I want to use Dialog as an example of how you can really do comprehensive, effective and compliant searching in order to comply with the regulations. So what is the guideline? So MEDDEV 2.71 revision 4 describes the clinical evaluation process for a medical device, and it assesses whether the clinical evidence is sufficient to confirm compliance with essential requirements for safety performance when the device is used according to the instructions for use. And it's very important that this goes on throughout the product life cycle. So pre-approval, in use, and post-approval. So for example, something that's been strengthened in the regulations is post-marketing surveillance of adverse events. And all of the information needs to be presented in a CER or clinical evaluation report. So the guidelines were brought in around 3 years ago, actually, in order to give manufacturers a three-year run-up, 3 years to get their house in order to understand and comply with the new regulations. The COVID pandemic caused a delay in the rollout of the guidelines, and there was a reprieve, and these guidelines now will go live in May 2021. And what prompted the European Medicines Agency to review the medical devices guidelines? Well, there was a need to catch up with advances in technology. Materials technology have moved on significantly since the time when these guidelines were originally written. And then the European Union has expanded to many new member countries. And there was a thought that there were different interpretations of the regulations across the different countries in the EU. So there was a need to really bring everybody together to look at them in the same way. There have also been very highly publicized problems with medical devices, particularly, for example, with the silicone breast implant scandal. So there's a lot of evidence to bear out the need for new guidelines in this area. Medical devices are classified into certain areas. And as you can imagine, something as simple as a band-aid or plaster has a lower risk of patient harm than something high risk, such as a pacemaker. So just a reminder that there are different classes and categorizations of medical devices. Now, the regulations are 300 pages of chapters and articles, so they're very long and they're quite complicated. And I am solely going to focus on where literature fits in. There are so many different facets to these regulations, and I'm just going to focus on literature. But let's have a look, first of all, at the clinical evaluation process. So the regulations are clear that manufacturers need to be vigilant from the beginning all the way through to when their product is in use. So as always with the beginning of a product, you need to define the needs and engage in R&D, where you need to look at clinical performance. Is your product efficacious? Can you demonstrate efficacy? Is it safety? Can you show equivalence to existing products that are on the market? And then it's very important then to get this CE approval, the EU CE approval. And then once the product is approved and it's on the market, you have to have ongoing clinical evaluation. So you cannot stop your vigilance there. And you have to do post-market surveillance for adverse events of the product in use in the population when it's being used according to the instructions. And of course, the manufacturers will be subject to audits by the competent authorities. So you have to be audit ready in order to save yourself a lot of time and extra expense, because audits can happen very unexpectedly and with short notice. So we're interested in literature today. So where in this very complicated 300-page document does literature feature? So it features in the clinical evaluation, the technical documentation, requirements to be met by the notified bodies, post-market clinical follow-up, the investigator's brochure, and the clinical investigation plan. So what does it mean? What does clinical data mean? Clinical data means information concerning the safety or the performance of a device. And it can be generated from the use of the device, so whether from healthcare practitioners, from clinical investigations of the device, or in studies reported in scientific literature. And the reports can be published in peer-reviewed scientific literature or based on other clinical experience. And then, very important, then clinically relevant information coming from post-market surveillance is important, and that's another area where the literature is a feature. So in the technical documentation, it clearly says in the regulations, for product evaluation and validation, preclinical and clinical data, including published literature, needs to be researched and demonstrated. A post-market surveillance plan needs to be put in operation for the collection and utilization of available information, in particular relevant specialist or technical literature, databases, or registers. In the requirements to be met by notified bodies and the post-market clinical follow-up, it says the notified body shall examine, validate, and verify that the manufacturer's processes, procedures, and documentation adequately address the scientific pre-clinical literature search. So this is very much the early stages of the life cycle of a medical device. And they also want to see the methodology for the literature search, and they want you to demonstrate documentation for the literature search. And it says that the notified body will conduct an in-depth review of the clinical evaluation, and it should be updated. The clinical evaluation should be updated by the manufacturer based on clinical literature relevant to the condition being treated with the device or similar devices. So it's very, very clear throughout the 300 pages that literature is a strong feature. And then in the investigator's brochure, the plan shall include the post-marketing clinical follow-up plan shall include at least the general methods and procedures of the PMCF to be applied, such as gathering of clinical evidence gained, feedback from users, so obviously from the field, from the population, from healthcare practitioners, from nursing staff, from the consumers, but going hand in hand with all this first level data, if you like, screening secondary sources, the screening of scientific literature. And then the investigator's brochure shall contain the clinical and non-clinical information on the investigational device. It shall contain information from relevant scientific literature available relating to safety, performance, clinical benefits, design characteristics, and intended purpose. So throughout all of these chapters, as you go through the regulations, they're being very clear on what part scientific literature might play. And then finally, the clinical investigation plan should set out a rationale, objectives, design methodology, monitoring, conduct, record keeping, and it shall contain the background literature review, the current state of the art in clinical care in the relevant field of application. So a lot of literature searches to be done.